Blackstone Audio presents Wanted, Dead or Alive, a Western Duo by Ray Hogan. This book is read by Patrick Lawlor. Between Life and Death. 1. Dade Lockett drew the big chestnut gelding he was riding to a quick halt in the deep brush. The muted thud of horses walking nearby had come to him through the darkening hush, arousing instantly the quick caution that countless days and nights on remote and lonely trails instills in all men. Silent, broad hand resting lightly on the worn butt of the pistol on his hip, he waited, listened. Somewhere ahead in the valley he was entering, a cow lowed mournfully, and high above it, a limp, ragged column of crows, winging westward, etched themselves blackly against the gray sky. He heard the sound again, this time more distinct, and accompanied by the dry swish of displaced branches whipping back into place. Fingers tightening about the handle of his weapon, he fixed his eyes on a dense stand of oak brush off to his right, where the noise seemed to originate. He froze as a voice cut through the stillness. "Forget it, mister." Lockett allowed his hand to slide away, hang at his side. There were two of them, and they had come in on him from opposite points that indicated they had spotted him before he had become aware of their presence. He settled back gently, swore. Both were wearing flour sacks over their heads, in which holes had been cut for eyes and mouths. Night riders. The pair closed in, one to the left, the other to his right. The sacks, bleached bone white in the failing light, had a drawstring that held them snugly about the neck and allowed the lower portion, slashed at the sides, to spread over the shoulders. These were no spur-of-the-moment makeshift masks, Dade realized. Undoubtedly, they were being used regularly. Their horses, ordinary-looking bays, were unbraided, as could be expected. He studied the riders briefly, shrugged. "Well, what's on your mind?" The man on his offside leaned forward, rested a forearm on the horn of his saddle. "Don't go getting wise with us or we'll mighty quick show you," he said in a hard voice. "Now what are you doing here?"
"Riding through."
"To where?" Lockett shook his head. He was on open range as far as he knew, and unless somebody'd got around to changing the custom, a man had the right to travel across such land as long as he did no damage and caused no trouble. "Don't see as it's any put-in of yours where I'm making it my put-in," the masked rider snapped, and reached for the coil of rope hanging from his saddle. Dade Lockett smiled bleakly.
"Now, if you're thinking about using that on me, best you change your mind," he drawled, his voice low, almost kind.
The man hesitated, glanced at his partner. "There's two of us, only one of you," he said. "You figure you can handle them odds?"
"I reckon."
"One thing for sure, when you get done making your move, there'll only be one of us left. And it'll be me or your friend here. Sure won't be you."
"Leave off the rope," the rider on the right said. His voice sounded deeper, more muffled. "Ain't no call for it near as I can see. Says he's riding through, maybe that's what he's doing."
"Then why is he so goddamn jumpy about answering questions?"
"Expect it's them flour sacks," Lockett said mildly. "Always had me sort of a thing about talking to somebody I couldn't see. Now, were you to pull them off?"
"Nope, guess not," the second man said. "This here place you're riding through to, it around close?"
"Place I'm heading for ain't so close, it being Tucson. Where I'm going right this minute, I ain't sure."
"Could it be to some folks named Raker?"
"Raker? Never heard of them. I was told there was a town called Mule Springs, however."
Silence greeted that. Finally, the man with the rope said, "What are you going there for? You got yourself a job of some kind lined up?" Dade grinned, wagged his head.
"You sure got the knack for asking questions that ain't none of your business. I'm making it my business."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.